Okay, so hi and hello, and you're probably wondering why I'm at the green screen area in my country park. And as many of you guys know, I love this game. I love theme park Tycoon 2. I love what the creator does with it. I love how accessibility, how the accessibility in it so well, and the replayability of it is amazing. But as a normal person does, I do have some issues with the game. Now, you might have seen Tygeman and Kosi were talk about this, so I'll take a few aspects from them and then add a bit of my own. And starting off first is accessibility, honestly. So the accessibility of the game in general is good, but if you want an idea, then you have to text Dennis on Twitter, of course. But small problem, he hasn't posted anything in about 3 years. The last thing he posted was something about not even Theme Park Tycoon 2, his other game, Water Park Tycoon. So even if you do text him about your idea, there is a high there's it's not being into the game. It's very AI message they sends to you. And also about just accessibility, there is no for example, other games on their Discord and everything, they post oh, this is update 5, everything coming in the next update. But with Theme Park Tycoon 2, you have to randomly guess when the monthly update is gonna come. So it could come 10 days before the last update, or it could come literally exactly a month later, or not even a month later, maybe a month and 10 days. So that's really what weirds me out, since you never know when the next update's gonna be. Because for example, my old park, I didn't know there was gonna be a park extension thingy. So I had to completely abandon that park since I was literally on the very last part of my park and making my roller coaster. So, I've been affected by just not being told about updates before they've actually been updated. So I think what would be a good change is try and make at least a Discord server. Now, there probably is a Discord somewhere, but I don't think it's owned by the actual owner of the game, Dennis. So if he makes an official Theme Park Tycoon 2 Discord, or at least just posts on his Roblox group that it's updates, or puts an announcement in the game, a little countdown in the corner saying update in whatever time, that would be very good. Now, a bit more about accessibility. I've had a ton of ideas for updates, but I haven't really talked about them, because why would I? Because they're not going to be added anyways. So here are a couple of my ideas, which I think will be kind of cool. So this is attached to the copy and paste update. I'm pretty sure some other games have something like this. I'm not sure if Bloxburg has it, since talking about Bloxburg, they like it's like 50% the same as Theme Park Tycoon, but they have everything I've just stated in the past 4 minutes. So they have telling you when there's gonna be a new update. It's gonna be announcements and stuff. And it really they reach out to the community, add community things. But anyways, back onto what I was saying. This reaches in within the copy and paste update. Basically, what I was gonna say, many other games do this, Bloxburg. I think any Lego game does it as well. Or some like the like I know some other games do this. Basically, there should be a public workshop with the copy and paste. So if copy and paste, you have all of your copy and paste features, and then basically you could upload your copy and pasted thingy onto a copy and paste workshop. And for example, people can pay credits to use your thingy that you've copy and pasted, which then they can use in their park. I'd say it's very good for ideas or just something you want to add to your park to build. And Another thing about, well, we're leading off from accessibility now. And now we're going to talk about the community. Now, this is like the least toxic community that I know. Everybody's very supportive, very like amazing, very like, kind, helpful when it comes to building. Like, I've been at a couple of these, I go to another puzzle park, check it out. They ask me if I can build a little something. I'm like, yeah, sure, I'll build here for like 10 minutes. And then eventually, I make a friend out of that. So, the community is one of the nicest I've seen in the any game community ever. But I'm talking about how the community is slowly branching away from Theme Park Tycoon. Because I'll throw up a screenshot on the screen right now, checking Rollymons. So, the player count has always been the same, but it is slowly dying down. Which, for a tycoon game, that's normal, but the thing is, it isn't, this tycoon game isn't really a tycoon game. It's like more of a free build game, which has infinite amount of replayability process. Because, like, I'm guessing people just quitting. Because why would they honestly like invest themselves into a game which has no like active creator? So, as we've seen on the screenshot, it always averages within 12,000, but now it's like it goes to 12,000 down to 6,000, 9,000, and then 12,000, and then it goes down, and then 12,000. During like holidays, yeah, during the summer mostly. And then, see, it's steadying to be the summer, and the play count's staying the same around 6,000. Now, this is really bad because if there's a dying community, then the creator wouldn't want to like just update the game, since why would he if no one's gonna like support? So, one thing he should do is like put a bit of marketing in the game. Or even hire like a team to like help him build stuff. Cause I know he's a single creator and like people like on it and stuff, like they only update like every 6 months. Which is like, yeah, that's understandable. Like Dennis uploading one like uploading update every once a month. That's good enough in itself for a tycoon game and only adding about like three new things in 1 month. That's very bad. So, what I'd say is you should try and get like a team, like at least one extra person helping him with all this stuff. So, that's all I really have to say, to be honest. I really do hope I see a good future of this game. Hopefully, I should post a video of my Theme Park Tycoon 2 Japanese area being finished, since all I have to do is build a couple of houses, finish the restaurant I was doing before it got corrupted, and yeah, I'm finished with the Japanese area, and we can move on with the American area. So, if you did enjoy this video, or enjoy my, like, facts, or not facts, like, enjoy my fair shared opinion on these videos on Dennis, then like and subscribe. And comment what you'd like me to speak about next if I do make a video like this. But yeah, have a good one, guys. See ya.